But then other experiences were fucking sick, you know, really sick. And we can get to that, you know. For me, like, the Wu-Tang Clan was the sickest shit ever, man.
Tell us about the Wu-Tang Clan experience. Yo, just so you know, I was in the crowd at that show.
Yeah.
We talked a little bit about that. So that's the July, I think, 2019 or whenever the fuck it was. I remember when it was.
Yeah.
I know it was there. And I was not having the same experience you had. I went in. I watched the DJ guy. I watched the Wu-Tang. I went home. But tell us about your version of that night.
So, like, we've known from the beginning that they changed my life. They were a huge influence, you know? So I've seen the Wu-Tang a lot also. I've seen them so many times at this point. In fucking Vancouver, solo member and group, right? In Vancouver, in Montreal, every fucking time. In Toronto and in New York. So I'm a fucking super fan, you know? I bought all the books. I've read every fucking article. I followed all these motherfuckers. I love the Wu-Tang. So, this is a dream come true. So, I come into work. I go buy fucking, because I don't have vinyl. I just have CD collection and my MP3s and shit. So, I go buy the fucking 36 chamber vinyl, of course. A nice silver marker. And, because I'm geeking out, for sure. So, I prepare. I'm with my little team. And everything's fucking beautiful. It's all set. It's clean. I know these guys, the history of these guys. I know that RZA is vegan. I know a little bit their lifestyles, you know? So we have, for lunch, it's like a sandwich bar, you know? So, burger bar. So it's the Beyond Meat just came out. So that's the craze for the vegans. So we got the whole vegan section. Then we got the meat section. And then we got the salad bar. And then we got this and that. And then it's all set, and I'm all waiting, and I have my vinyl on the other side and shit. And I'm nervous as fuck, dude. Like, I'm shaking, and I'm just waiting for that moment. I had met RZA at, like, a signing. I never go to signings, but I went for a Jazz Fest signing at one point. I took a picture with RZA, and I signed, like, one of his DigiSnack CD there. And other than that, I never geek out. I never go to signings and stuff. So I'm fucking nervous, dude. I'm shaking and stuff, and I'm with some people from Sandel that always come, like some managers and stuff, and I'm telling them this is my best band in the world. If you tell me you can only listen to one band, it's Wu-Tang, you know? I'm like, I can't fucking believe that I'm going to see all these guys here, and I'm cooking for them. This is a dream. So then I'm preparing and all that. First person to come into the cafeteria is the RZA. I see the RZA, and I freeze, and I just say, "The Abbott," and I'm like a fucking kid. I just like "The Abbott," and he's like, "Boom, boom, what's going on? Boom, boom, what's good? What are we eating? What are we eating?" You know? And then I'm like, "Oh, we have a burger bar. I know you're vegan. We have some Beyond Burgers. Oh yeah, I got Beyond Burgers. Oh, that's the shit." He's with you at YDB, so that's like, I'm like, that's the first tour where fucking YDB represents his fucking father, ODB. So that's touching as fuck. And he's with his uncle, RZA. I'm like, wow, this is fucking awesome. And then they start, they get their food and all that. I start talking to them a little bit, you know. I remember one moment where I shake the hand of YDB and said, "Hey, man, I just want to tell you I'm a huge fan of your father. And I want to tell you how much I respect what you're doing right now to carry on his legacy and how proud he would be, you know." And, man, he was touched, you know? He's a human being. He was like, "Ah, thank you, man. That means a lot," you know? And then it was like, every time I go back and forth, I was, like, geeking out and blurring some shit out, you know? It was like, RZA's really cool. And it was cool because they were sitting together, I guess, an uncle and nephew. And they stayed, like, for almost 5 hours, those two, in the cafeteria. They could have been in the bus. They could have been in their private lodge. But, no, they're cafeteria, man. Very normal. Talk about whatever. And they're enjoying their meal. And every time I'm coming, every half an hour or something, geeking out, I'm like, "Dude, I've been listening to you. This is first six chamber. I saw you guys maybe 20 times, man." One point I say, "Oh, the geekiest fucking shit ever." Because I have a song on the, I have a song called Connect on the album Sound Barriers. And that's with Kinetic 9 from Killer Army Wu-Tang. So Kinetic 9 was the hype man of RZA for a long time when he did his solo stuff. Kinetic 9 was his hype man, and on every RZA solo album, Kinetic 9 is featured on one song or the other. And he's from Killer Army. I hooked up with Kinetic 9 when Twitter came out. I hooked up with him and we did a song by distance, and that was that. I ended up on fucking Wu-Tang blog spot and this and that and all types of Wu-Tang shit. I got some followers. I premiered on the Next Level Ice-T Sirius radio thing. That was the premiere of the song. That was some hype shit, right? So I cross fucking RZA. I'm all nervous like a fucking nerd, and I'm like, yeah, RZA, I know Kinetic 9. Oh, yeah, Kinetic 9's my man. I say, yeah, I did a rap song with him. Total nerd. I was like, yeah, I do a little rapping. I said I do a little rapping like a fucking dweeb. And then he just, I did a rap song with him. I do a little rapping like a fucking geek, dude, all nervous. And then he's just like laughs a little bit. He's like, oh, yeah, that's cool. Like, probably not believing me at all. So every time I pass next to him, I'm saying some stupid shit, dude. But he was cool. He was super nice, man. Then fucking Capadonna comes in. Capadonna's pretty big, you know. He's a pretty massive guy. Tall. Comes in. He's like, oh, what's up? It smells like a high school cafeteria in here. What are we eating? I'm like, I hear that voice, man, that rugged voice. I'm like, Capadonna. He's like, yeah. I'm like, dude, welcome. He's like, a burger bar, this and that. Oh, cool, cool. And he sits down on his own, starts eating. 15 minutes later, he's like, did you cook all this? I'm like, hell yeah, I cooked all this. That's fucking good. You did a good job. I said, yeah, well, you know, I tried my best for the best. He said, you did your best, man. You know, dude, those fucking phrases I'm going to remember till I die, man. These little phrases, you know, these little interactions as a super fan. Then fucking Chef comes in. He's all short, man. He's all short and round and cute. Chef comes in with his big smile. He's the smiliest guy. I'm like, Chef. He comes in. I freeze. I'm like, Chef. He's like, hey, how you doing, man? I'm like, good. He said, oh, what are we eating at? I said, we're eating burgers. Cool, awesome, this and that. And then he's serving him, and I'm just kind of standing there next to the door looking around. And then my dishwasher's not at that point, is next to me, and he's like, holy shit, that's rec one, you know. And then he's like, this is nice buffet, this is high class, this is good, man. So dude, I like this, a lot of stuff. And then he looks at me, he says, I have my vest, it says Chef on it, the Huckett, nice designer vest. And then he says, are you the chef? This is the chef talking to me. I said, are you the chef? He said, are you the chef? I said, yeah, I'm the chef. He said, you look like a chef. Dude, the chef tells me you look like a chef. I'm like, thanks, man. Can I have a picture with you? Yeah, man, no problem. I take a picture with the chef. I'm like, this is out of this fucking world. I'm a chef, huge fan of Wu-Tang. And I'm taking a fucking picture with Rec One, the chef, that just told me I'm the chef. I can amazing. Die, dude. I can fucking die, you know? Last person that I had a real interaction with is Ghostface Killah. He's one of the fucking, like, strongest members of the Wu-Tang, you know? And so constant, so many classic albums, dude. And he's a big fucking guy. So he comes in, only person with security. I'm like, okay, shit is serious. Comes in. I'm like, Ghostface. He's like, hey, how you doing? I'm like, good, welcome to Montreal. The food, if you need anything, tell me, this and that. And then he serves, he's kind of, seems on a little bit on the phone, a little bit in his mind and stuff. He does his thing, he eats, his security is standing in the doorway. I come back and at this point, I made Chef sign the album. Also, I wanted those signatures. So Chef signed the album. Cap signed the album at this point. YDB signed the album at this point. I had asked RZA. He told me to wait. So I wait. I want that, too. I'm totally fucking geeking out. And then I come back. I think he's finished because his plate is on the side, and he seems finished. Goes. So I'm like, excuse me, Ghostface, you think you can sign my album like a fucking 12-year-old kid? And then he's like, I'm eating, man. I'm eating, man, after. I'm like, oh, shit, I'm sorry, I didn't want to barter, you know? And he's like, no, no problem. It's just like, I don't want to get your vinyl dirty and shit. I'm like, okay, it's cool. He said, I'll let you know. I'm like, okay. And then I just feel bad for a moment. I'm like, oh, fuck. I fucking disturbed him, you know? And then whatever, back and forth. Go back to bring something into the buffet. Dude pushes his fucking chair. He's like all spread out and shit. Fucking Ghostface killer. Then he looks at me and he says, you ready, boss? I'm like a fucking 10-year-old child. I'm like, yes, yes. And I just go run, get my vinyl. And he signs the vinyl. Fuck, man. So that's that. I don't see the other guys. They're in their buses or whatever. And so I see these five guys, which is huge. And then they leave. They do a sound check. They come back for supper. Okay, this is the moment, man. So it's like ratatouille, all these vegetables and lasagna, veggie and all that, the vegan guys. And then they eat. Some people eat, some people from the staff. There's less of them at that point. And then RZA comes at last minute, and he's the general, and he has all his gear on with his nice jewelry and shit, looking sharp. And he comes real quick, and then he comes to see me. He says, hey, chef, you still have some those Beyond Meat burgers? And we changed the menu, right? But in the fucking dishwasher zone, right next to the garbage, there's some Beyond Meat burgers. But they're supposed to be in the garbage because I can't give food that's 3-4 hours old. I'm going to poison the fucking Wu-Tang Clan. So then I'm like, this is the moment where the RZA asks me for something that he wants, you know? He's like, hey, chef, do you still have those Beyond Meat burgers? And I'm like, I'm ripped. My soul is ripped apart. I'm just like, no, man. I'm sorry. We have ratatouille and some vegan lasagna and all this stuff. Like, yeah, I really wanted a Beyond burger, you know? And I'm like, oh, I'm sorry. We changed the menu. He said, you don't have any more in the back? I said, no, I cooked everything, you know? And then he looks in the dishwasher section, and then he's like, what about those? And I'm like, I feel so bad, dude. I'm saying no to, like, one of my idols, dude. And I'm like, they're supposed to be in the garbage. I'm really sorry. I can't give you those. I don't want you to be sick, man. He's like, okay, fair. That's good. No problem, man. And then I ask him, you think you can sign my vinyl? After denying him a Beyond Burger, dude. He's like, yeah.
He's way less enthused than you want in this moment.
Dude, that was the day I knew I could fucking die after that, man. That was the best it could get in kitchen.
I think single-handedly that is the longest single story. Yo, Chris used the whole thing as a clip. We're already on the Wu-Tang blog one time. They might put that clip on the Wu-Tang blog.
The whole thing is a clip.
It's amazing, dude. It is really it was incredibly entertaining to listen to. Your passion just carries it. Like, you can't. That was, like, nobody can really, with that much detail, describe one of the best moments of their lives, in my opinion. Like, nobody can until we get Lucky Lex. But how many of us, like, really get the opportunity to make food for the Wu-Tang Clan, get complimented by the Wu-Tang Clan, interact with them, have all these goofy moments? Because you're stuck with them, right? Like, it's not even, let's say they got completely sour. You're still spending the rest of the day with the Wu-Tang Clan.